Hey guys, what's up? Chief Pat here, and today bringing you guys a brand new Clash Royale video. And today we're gonna be trying out a new deck on my main account using the log. And since my log is only level 2, I thought the only way to make it fair would be to bring Amir along with me, and hopefully we can get some double log action going on. So I'm gonna try to save up a little bit of elixir with my elixir pump, and then hopefully go for like a mini P.E.K.K.A. or a Hog Rider double log push. And let's go ahead and let that mini P.E.K.K.A. run down the lane. Looks like it's gonna hit that Ice Wizard just once, and he's got a prince that's gonna run down on offense. So seeing what I can play, I'm just gonna drop a cannon to help out. I'll drop the Ice Wizard on top of his Ice Wizard, and that should be able to take him out. And yeah, we should be able to hold on to defense right here. Not gonna play anything in front of that prince as well, and since he played those arrows, I'm thinking we have a pretty decent elixir lead right now. All right, so Musketeer in the back, let's get ready for a log push. I'm gonna play another elixir collector on the bottom left, and at this point the game is pretty much in our control, especially because we have the level 2 log. Nothing could be better. And let's go ahead and play the Hog Rider. I'm going to follow up with a log on the right hand lane, and of course one level 2 log won't take care of a level 4 princess, so I'm going to drop a second log, and that's going to be able to take that princess out. Some great value right there. 5 elixir to take out a princess, you guys know what it is. Musketeer is going to take out that left hand tower, and just like that, the first tower of the game has gone down. So he says, well played. He's wondering what the heck I'm doing with double logs. He's using the, I guess, double prince. He might have a P.E.K.K.A. inside of there as well, with the Ice Wizard. That's sort of standard with P.E.K.K.A. double prince. Looks like his prince is gonna die as soon as it charges down that cannon. At this point, we're looking pretty groovy, and I'm gonna play another elixir collector towards the back. Now, of course, the log obviously can't attack anything in the air, nor can it attack anything behind the towers, which really makes it one of the weaker, if not the weakest cards in the game right now, which is sort of a bummer for being a legendary, at least as far as I've seen. Let's play the Hog Rider double log push. You can see the Hog Rider is sort of like floating right there while the logs were going down the lane. And yeah, looks like that tower's gonna go all the way down to 2086. Not too shabby, and we're gonna have to play a little bit of defense against this P.E.K.K.A. and to try to hold off this push. All right, so another princess in the back means we're gonna have to get a double log combo going. He does have the double princes on the left-hand side, so let's go ahead and get our cannon to distract those. We'll play another cannon after they're done charging, and he's actually gonna play a freeze spell, which means that we might have to drop another Ice Wizard to take care of that prince before it attacks my Musketeer. So princess is gonna go down, Hog Rider and a log, aka the Log Rider, going down the right-hand lane, and a Musketeer as well in the very center to try to wrap up that three-crown victory and to make sure that this prince goes down. All right, so far so good. Mini P.E.K.K.A. is charging. I got the cannon for style points in the very center. The double log combo proved to be pretty effective during this battle against P.E.K.K.A. double prince, giving us that 3-0 victory. So level 2 log, a little bit underwhelming, especially since I can't one-shot a princess, which is really what the log is good for. I feel like that's its one benefit over all of the other spell cards. Obviously the arrows can one-shot the princess and upwards, but for 2 elixir, being able to one-shot a princess is pretty nice. But at level 2, I can only kill a level 3 princess and below. Another level 4 princess means my log is going to be pretty much useless, so let's drop a double log combo onto this princess. And yeah, at least we'll take the princess out at the cost of 5 elixir. So meanwhile, he's like, hey, this idiot's running a log. Let me drop the minion horde down the left-hand lane. I'm going to have to drop my cannon to distract as well as a musketeer to try to help out. And we're actually going to be able to take care of that push before things get a little bit too ugly. And need to remember that he has the minion horde to make sure I save either my Ice Wizard or I save my musketeer, because obviously the log really isn't going to be doing too much for me except for taking out the princess during this match. All right, so Elixir Collector in my hand, gonna go ahead and play that in the bottom right since he played his in the top left. Remember guys, play your Elixir Collector behind the tower that has more HP, and that's what I'm gonna do on the bottom right. And taking a look at which side I want to attack, it doesn't really matter. I guess I'll just go for the left-hand lane to try to go opposite of this giant skeleton and get ready for a big push down the left-hand lane. Now, of course, I'm gonna have to drop something to stop this giant skeleton, but I can't find the right thing to play just yet. But of course, princess going down means it's log time. We've got the first log, which actually run over the cannon for a second. The second log is gonna miss the princess. And meanwhile, on the right-hand lane, the mini P.E.K.K.A. actually reaches the giant skeleton too late. So this is a little bit of a disaster of a game so far. That giant bomb is gonna do a ton of damage on the right-hand lane. The minion horde's gonna go crazy and to take out that mini P.E.K.K.A. Meanwhile, the Ice Wizard to take out the minion horde and the musketeer on the left-hand lane. He's actually gonna drop a miner, so my log is gonna miss most of those goblins. So this is, yeah, this is really sloppy so far. We're gonna have to to step it up. Obviously, that cannon is going to get outranged by my musketeer. That's going to work really well for us. Meanwhile, his princess is going to be too far back to do too much. I'm actually going to mirror the Hog Rider, which is just a mind-numbing decision. I guess we'll get a single shot off against the tower while my Ice Wizard sort of just hangs out. Meanwhile, he's got the giant skeleton down. The minions are going to get in front of it, so luckily I'm not going to have to drop my musketeer to try to do anything crazy. And the log is going to make some crazy value right here with these goblins. Even though it moves so slow, it's almost impossible to react to the goblin barrel. We're actually going to take out the tower on the left-hand side of the mini P.E.K.K.A. And we can pull out a victory as long as things don't go a little bit too weird. So a sloppy game overall, but the double logs just propelling us to victory. Let's drop a mini P.E.K.K.A. on top of the princess. We've got three troops in the battlefield. We got the Hog Rider, and this one is pretty much over. We're going to take a 1-0 victory. Somehow the logs were able to pull it out, and we can stop the giant skeleton in its tracks with the cannon in the very center. So good game. Log turned out to be pretty okay right there, I guess. Of course, if I had it level 3, I could at least take care of a level 4 princess. I'm not sure if a level 3 takes care of a level 5 princess as well. I would doubt it. I guess you might need a level 4. But let's go and get into another battle right here and keep trying this log combo out. So musketeer in the very back to start off. Let's get ready to see what Yannicky is going to say. Oh, I'm just totally butchering names, as usual. One of the worst parts of trying to do this. Okay, anyways, musketeer is down. We've got the Ice Wizard to follow up. He's got his witch, which should be pretty easy to take out. Three musketeers. Okay, I'm going to have to drop my log. And the log, of course, is going to take a while. My musketeer is actually dead by the time the log makes it down the lane. But of course, no one expects the second log. And wait, because we mirrored our log. That log actually was able to take care of the princess. So forgot that the mirror gives your legendary an additional level or two or whatever it is. So that princess actually died in a single log. And yeah, that worked out pretty decently. All right, so another elixir collector in the back. And at this point, he played that princess right when I was playing that log. So I think we have a decent elixir lead right now. And we should be able to do a pretty awesome push. So musketeer on the right. We've got our level 5 ice wizard as well. He's got a hog rider, so I can just play my mini P.E.K.K.A. instead of a cannon. No need to waste a building and just set up for a counter push. So now we've got all these troops down. We've got our hog rider, aka the log rider, because the log is coming right behind it. We've got the double logs. Not sure what he's going to do about this, except for drop a free spell, and the logs just roll into the tower and doing 100 damage right there, really carrying the game to a victory. So Hog Rider is still at full HP, even with that free spell, and this guy being level 13. We got two musketeers, two ice wizards, two logs, two chains, and a 3 crowns for a pretty simple win. So good game. Obviously, that mirrored log worked out pretty well against the princess and helped us get that 3-crown victory for 18 trophies. Let's go ahead and hop into one more battle using this combination before I gotta wash my hands, and that's gonna be against Jeff. And let's see what starting cards we have to play. Now, of course, don't want to play the log as our starting card unless I just want to intimidate my opponent. So I'm going to play the Ice Wizard in the very back. We've got the Elixir Collector on tap in case we want to use it, but instead, going to drop the cannon. I'm going to drop the log. Looks like the goblins should get run over by that log, as well as the princess is going to get redirected to the cannon because of the log, which actually turned out to be pretty interesting as far as their dynamics went. And then meanwhile, Mini P.E.K.K.A. and the Ice Wizard running down the lane. The Mini P.E.K.K.A. is going to take out that cannon and maybe even get close. Okay, never mind. Not going to get to the tower with the minions, but the minions are going to die to our tower instead of the Ice Wizard. And we've got a pretty decent shot so far. So we haven't damaged his towers, but as far as our elixir trades are going, we definitely are in the lead. And we have a full elixir pump down, and we're almost at 10 elixir right now. So let's play our musketeer in the back. Let's set up for a nice push on our side of the map. And of course, he's gonna play his level 4 princess, so we're gonna have to cycle to our log because the log is the way to victory right now. All right, so log is gonna go down. Just a second, maybe I can hold off and play an ice wizard instead. So I'm gonna mirror both of those ice wizards instead of dropping the log. We're gonna go ahead and get some value out of that. And now comes the log rider. The log's gonna be flowing down the lane towards the mini P.E.K.K.A. Looks like it's actually gonna hit the tower as well, and the goblins are gonna get destroyed by our level 5 ice wizard. And even with two level 5 ice wizards go into that P.E.K.K.A., it doesn't look like they're gonna do enough damage. So I'm just gonna sit back, let that mini P.E.K.K.A. go down, and sit back for another push down the right-hand lane. So pretty even so far. He's got 2856, I'm at 2739. Doesn't look like too many 3-crown victories are gonna come out with this deck. And because of that cannon, he actually has a single minion going towards our tower, which means we're gonna have to take a little bit of damage to our Ice Wizard. Our Ice Wizard actually might die, but instead a single HP. So I'm just gonna let him run down the lane and eventually meet his maker. But still, Elixir Pump is down. We can play our Musketeer in the back, and this is where we should be able to make a pretty meaty push, I guess. So the log, aka the double log, gonna go down the right-hand lane to kill the princess. I was hoping he would drop something right on top of them, but didn't end up doing that. And there goes the mini P.E.K.K.A. So instead of doing anything aggressive, I didn't really have anything to play. I'm just gonna let my Musketeer die and just go on the defensive with the Ice Wizard and wait for that mini P.E.K.K.A. push. All right, so here's where we should be able to make a play. We've got the mini P.E.K.K.A. getting a hit off against our Musketeer. Still has a little bit of HP left, but here comes the mini P.E.K.K.A. Hog Rider, Ice Wizard, Musketeer, double log push, the longest push in the history of pushes. Gonna make it to the tower with the mini P.E.K.K.A. getting two hits off against the tower to bring it down to 700. We've got the princess in the back that's firing away, but still we've got our Musketeer and the cannon to help out against this Hog Rider push. His zap really won't do too much. It should reset my Musketeer for just a moment. Will die to that princess right there. But again, let's go for another Hog Rider push. I'm trying to get this game to be over. We've got the log running over the goblins. We've got the log running into the tower yet again. And it looks like we're gonna take the tower all the way down to 454. I'm trying to get a single hit off on the tower with this Musketeer. We're getting really close to the range where our log could actually kill the tower. And since it's at 198, I actually think the log could wrap up this game. No better way to finish off this video than with the log. Let's drop log number one. Let's drop log number two. We're not actually even gonna need our troops because the log is gonna take us to victory and wrap up a 1-0 victory against Jeff. So guys, that is the mirrored log deck, aka the log rider when you bring in the log. If you guys think this deck is somewhat interesting, you guys feel free to try it if you have the log as far as your legendary cards go. But instead, I'll probably put it into the safe for now until I get a higher level log. But yeah, that is going to do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you drop a like. Until next time, I will see you guys later. Peace out.